What do you think on the election of 1900? What do you think about the election of 1912?
Personally, I was rooting for Debs.
I was rooting for Woodrow Wilson, but also like the Buckskin thing. What was that? Let me just flip to my notes.
The Moose, Bull Moose Party.
Bull Moose, yep. All I know is that Eugene won our class election and I drew the poster, so pretty much I won the election of 1912, is what I'm hearing. Basically, Hawaii, we were imperialistic and we stole it.
I don't like this game.
The election of 1912. The Socialists put up Debs, but he was too radical. The Republicans put up Taft, but he was too disliked. And they did not stand a chance in the race for the presidency. The Bull Moose Party put up Roosevelt. He supported a new nationalism to break up trusts and regulate government. He wanted to limit government and big business and reach out to African American voters, which he did, but he did not pull through with his promises. That is why, he addressed Congress in person, which started out
it's a history check.
It started out the, what's it called? The
communists.
The Gettysburg Address.
He was the first, he started out the State of the Unions.
This is before the Depression, right?
Yeah. For me?
These are my notes on the Great Depression.
I love it.
Thank you.
Imperialism. First, social Darwinism. We felt that we were the best people and we needed to end up with the wealth and all the land. We felt strongly that we needed to go and be Christians and Christianize other groups. Industrialization. We were seeking new markets and places to sell our goods.
Side note, would you like the 7 factors of industrialization?
Yes, I have those.
Number 1, natural resources. Iron ore, timber, water, and coal. Number 2, labor supply. Parentheses, workers. There's a high birth rate. People were immigrating left and right. And there were also women and children. What that has to do with anything, I don't know. But there were women and children.
The Child Labor Act of 1916. No product made by children under 14 could be sold across state lines. This made it unprofitable to have child workers.
Okay.
Well, the third factor.
Little Miss Videographer.
Yeah, that's me.
Third factor is technology, which you're using right now and it's not. So maybe you should focus on me.
I think Freddy.
Technology, communication, telegraph, and the phone.
Oh, ring ring hello?
Is this Woodrow Wilson?
You betcha.
Do you know the 7 factors of industrialization?
I do know.
Yeah.
Transportation.
You guys need help.
Cars were not a thing yet.
No transportation.
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 You know what they were using?
Transportation.
They were using them rivers.
Horse and buggy.
They were using the canals. They were using the roads with their railroad.
The Erie Canal. I have no clue when it was built, but I probably should. And it made us a world player because we can now get to Canada, I think. I really don't know.
Wrong answers only. When was the election of 1912?
Actually, 1969.
Woodrow Wilson.
This is my time.
Sorry.
Keep going. Money was used to expand or start a business. Bank loans, they were happening. And also, stealth. Spoiler alert, Great Depression.
Back to imperialism. The final reason was military. We had the strength and we wanted to grow on those.
We got the meat.
That is why we went
Hawaii. Oh, look at those notes. That's so satisfying.
These are my worst notes. Well, they're maybe not my worst.
Yes.
Yay.
I am.
Kendra and Fee.
Overseas.
Wait,
market.
What time is
Sophia.
It? Sophia. 3:30.
I might have to skate out a little early.
Overseas.
Yes.
Oh god. The teacher's coming. There she is.
Anyways, the urban environment. William DuBois. The first African-American to graduate with a PhD. Look how dry my hand is. Does anyone have lotion?
I do have lotion, actually.
Are you?
It's recording. I made it record.
On a plane. I lost it on
I don't put hand lotion on my face.
The scent is Irish.
Absolutely not. Absolutely.
Where is
the
it?
Fuck.
Okay.
Not. Yes?
Political machines.
Oh, political machines. They do be machining.
I thought that wasn't even English.
Political machine?
Yes. Do you guys think I should become David Dobrik? I'm really good at like the whole...
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So do you want to see a video of me?
Yes, I love to see videos. Do you want to be in our fun little history video? Oh my god.
Here it is.
Oh my god, cute.
So this is the History Channel. Today we're learning about imperialism, industrialization, and my biffle, Eugene V. Debs, socialist.
Uh-huh.
I am Elise Abbott, and I'm your worst nightmare. Oh. Oh.
Hi, my name is Sophia from AP US History, and you are watching the History Channel.
Kendra ripped the background. She ripped the background. I'm looking at it right now and it's ripped. And it wasn't ripped before.
We were late.
To World War II?
One. We were late to World War I. But that's okay because it was a counterbalance because Russia dropped out. The war was already settled in the trench warfare.
A couple of roundhouse kicks later.
There was a blockade between Britain and France to trade with the US. Unrestricted submarine warfare.
Security?
Thank you. Just monochrome things.
We struggled with neutrality because we came out of a recession. I'm in hell.
Mama had me in jail. Already not average. 1 pound, fat head, came out the womb, I was dead. Obviously, it was a bad kid. The first thing I did was explore.
I got it.
I love
and mac and cheese and
Tom Holland, Marvel, Spider-Man. I'm bringing sexy back.
Eugene V. Debs could come back from the dead. I would marry him on spot. Ha ha ha. JK.
And this.